Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I wanted to talk about something that's been on my mind for a long time. Why I switched from doing Five Nights at Freddy's Funko Snap stop motions to Lego stop motions. I know, I was one of the only people keeping the Funko Snaps train going, but today I'm going to explain why I've made the leap to Lego, and honestly, why I'm so excited about it. Reason number one, and this is probably one of the biggest, Lego minifigures are just way more poseable for stop motion. With the Funko Snaps figures, you're kind of stuck with limited movement. The heads and torsos can snap on and off, the arms move a bit, but that's really all. But with Lego, you get fully poseable arms, legs, heads, you name it. You can create so many more dynamic scenes with Lego figures, whether it's running, jumping, or more complex motions like climbing or fighting. For stop motion, poseability is everything, and Lego just gives so much more freedom. And in the market of bootleg Lego figures, which I'll touch on in just a second, there's this special type that have way more poseability, with joints halfway through the arms, legs, ball joints on the arm sockets, and poseable heads. Now, let's talk about cost. This one's gonna surprise some of you, but Lego, especially when we're talking about bootleg or off-brand versions, come out way cheaper than Funko Snaps. Funko Snaps figures are expensive, $20 for two figures, and if you want to collect a bunch of them for stop motion, it adds up real fast. But with bootleg Lego, I can get tons of different figures for a fraction of the cost, even of official Lego. They're easy to modify too, so I can customize them to fit any scene or character I want. I know some people are all about the official Lego brand, but for what I'm doing, bootlegs are a perfect way to expand my collection without breaking the bank. That brings me to my next point, variety. With Lego, even with bootlegs too, the possibilities are endless. You've got characters from literally every universe. Star Wars, Marvel, Harry Potter, Lord of the Rings, Minecraft, and that's just scratching the surface. Funko Snaps? It was really only FNAF characters. Don't get me wrong, I love the Five Nights at Freddy's franchise, but after a while, the creative options felt limited. Like, you can only make different characters do different stuff only so many times before it just gets old and repetitive. But with Lego, on the other hand, I can mix and match characters, create original stories, or mash up characters from any franchise ever. It's really opened up my creativity in ways I didn't expect, and this is the exact reason I started my channel off with Lego Stop Motion. Finally, let's be real. Funko Snaps kind of died a while ago. I felt like I was one of the last people keeping that part of the FNAF community alive. Don't get me wrong, it was a fun journey while it lasted, but there's only so long you can keep a fading trend going. The support just wasn't there anymore, and even though I was proud to contribute to it, it's time to move on to something bigger and better. Lego, on the other hand, isn't going anywhere. There's a huge community out there, tons of inspiration, and let's be honest, it's still growing. Jumping into Lego feels like I'm riding a wave that's just getting started. So, those are the reasons why I'm making the switch. More poseable figures, cheaper options, a huge variety, and honestly, it's just time to move on. Funko Snaps had its moment, but for stop motion animation, Lego gives me the tools to tell bigger and better stories. Hey guys, thanks for sticking around. I hope you guys are excited for what's to come. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any of the new Lego stop motion content I've got in the works. And hey, if you're still repping Funko Snaps, drop a comment below. I'd love to hear your thoughts, but for now, it's all about Lego for me. Catch you guys in the next one.